humans, on their endeavour to explore the vast expanses of seemingly infinite outer space, have till now discovered not more than 4% of it. All thanks to decades of research and development. But, the thirst of exploration is yet to be quenched. And this could mean that the next phase of space exploration could be the most thrilling of all, as this time, the best minds in both government and private sectors are working together to achieve the same goal. What's new this time is that the companies themselves have ambitions beyond government contracts. From building the biggest rocket ever, to space tourism, and from colonizing Mars, to mining the moon. The new space race between nations and companies are setting new trends in space exploration. Leading the pack is none other than the United States of America. Be it government or private, the USA has been a leader in space exploration since decades. We need not mention the achievements made by NASA, and continuing the legacy, are private companies like SpaceX, Virgin Galactic, Blue Origins, and the United Launch Alliance. All are in race on setting new records in private spaceflight. From building the heaviest rocket till date, to launching commercial astronauts into space. Only time will tell what new benchmarks will be set by these ambitious companies. Next comes Russia. The first country to launch a man-made object into orbit, thus sparking the first space race ever. Although almost all Russian spaceflight companies are either partially or fully owned by the Russian government, we cannot ignore their contribution towards space exploration. From world's first privately funded space station Mir, by Mir Corporation, to the Soyuz launch vehicle and spacecraft, which is currently the only way to and from the ISS, manufactured by Progress Rocket Space Center and RKK Energy respectively. And not to forget, the International Launch Services, which manufactures Russia's only heavy lift launch vehicles, the Angara A5 and the Proton M. The European Space Agency is not far behind either when it comes to space exploration. It may not have as many feathers under its cap, but we cannot ignore its contribution towards the ISS, the Hubble Space Telescope, and the Rosetta mission. And not to forget, Arianespace, Europe's premier aerospace company, responsible for Europe's only heavy lift launch vehicle, the Ariane 5, which currently holds the record for lifting heaviest load of 10,865 kilograms or 23,953 pounds, to geosynchronous transfer orbit. With these capabilities under its belt, the only thing Europe lacks is an ambitious space program. And thus we are very optimistic that Europe's space capabilities will prove to be crucial in giving Europe an edge in the current space race. Now let's talk about a country which seems to be extra serious about its space program, a country desperately trying to win the space race. And that country is China. It's been a roller coaster ride for the Chinese Space Agency. It seems to be in a hurry to prove that it can mimic every space achievements made by other space agencies, from independently launching its own space station and conducting a spacewalk, to landing a rover to the far side of the moon. And from launching the most capable dark matter explorer satellite, to launching world's first quantum communication satellite. China has proved its mettle. But despite these groundbreaking achievements, it also has experienced a lot of very embarrassing failures. From crucial satellites failing to enter Earth orbit, to declaring its heavy lift rocket operational after just two launches, of which both were partial failures. And not to forget, used rocket stages falling onto villages instead of sea, and the list goes on. And so we would suggest China to slow down a bit and focus on quality more than quantity. And to give more freedom to private Chinese space companies like OneSpace, LandSpace, LinkSpace, and XSpace. Allowing them to showcase their capabilities. And last but not the least, the Indian Space Agency, also known as the Sleeping Giants, has shown the world what it is capable of, from launching more than 100 satellites into space in a single launch, to making it to Mars in the first attempt. It has all the characteristics to be the dark horse of the current space industry. But honestly, we feel that the Indian Space Agency takes its own sweet time in accomplishing a given task, and when it does, they just can't get over its success. It's been over a decade since India's first mission to the moon, and over 5 years since their first Mars mission, and they are still celebrating over it. We agree that it is a great achievement, but what next? Comparing it to the Chinese lunar program, which is currently already halfway through, in their mission of going from a moon orbiter to a manned moon mission, within a span of 20 years, that began in 2007. Not only that, the Chinese are even working on a manned mission to Mars, by 2050. On the other hand, India is currently just thinking about their second Mars mission. What is more surprising is the fact that Team Indus, a private Indian space company, after getting inspired by the success of India's first lunar mission, was able to build a lander and rover for the moon, much before country's premier space organization could, but was unable to launch it into space, due to lack of funds. We find it absurd that a country with well over 300,000 millionaires and over 100 billionaires, which includes the richest man in Asia, who is also the 18th richest man in the world, could not afford $15 million for a rocket launch. But what is most surprising is the fact that the Indian Space Research Organization, which has been present since around half a century, is not even thinking about building a heavy lift launch vehicle. India's workhorse, the PSLV, is only capable of lifting 4,000 kilograms, or 8,800 pounds into LEO. Not only that, India's most powerful rocket, the GSLV Mark III, can only lift 8,000 kilograms, or 18,000 pounds into LEO, which is minuscule when compared to Falcon 9's lifting capabilities, that can easily lift 22,800 kilograms, or 50,265 pounds into LEO, and was built by a company, headed by a guy, with no experience, with half the budget of ISRO, and in under one-third of the time. SpaceX has even successfully tested Falcon Heavy, which can lift 63,800 kilograms, or 140,660 pounds into LEO. And while SpaceX's big Falcon rocket concept will be designed to lift well over 100,000 kilograms, or 220,000 pounds, into LEO, ISRO's GSLV Mark IV concept will only be designed to lift 15,000 kilograms, or 33,000 pounds into LEO. To know more on GSLV Mark IV, click on the I symbol on the top right corner, or go to the end of the video. And to give you a quick overview, all major space agencies around the world generally only use rockets which can at least lift 20,000 kilograms, or 44,000 pounds into LEO. Falcon 9, Ariane 5, Atlas 5, Delta 4, Vulcan, Long March 5, and Proton M are few of the workhorses from around the world that fall under this category. Before we end this video, we would like to draw your attention towards another, not much known space agency, which is none other than the Japanese Space Agency. JAXA, along with private Japanese space companies like Mitsubishi Heavy Industries and Kawasaki Heavy Industries, also have some notable space achievements under their belt. Some of these include having its own space lab, asteroid exploration missions, an active launch vehicle as powerful as India's rumored GSLV Mark IV, the only Asian country to launch a solar sail-fitted spacecraft, along with spacecrafts powered by indigenous plasma thrusters, indigenous ion thrusters, and even indigenous Hall thrusters. All these capabilities can even spark an Asian space race. Type yes in the comment section below if you want a comparison video between ISRO, JAXA, and CNSA. To sum it all up, India neither lacks the funds, nor the brains, and their past achievements are a proof that India can achieve far greater than what it has already achieved in all these years. It's time now for the sleeping giant to finally wake up before it's too late. As the turtle might win the race in fairy tales, but in real life, it's the hare which usually takes the cake. We believe that if India fails to take on this new space race seriously, then China, or even SpaceX, could easily turn out to be the clear winner. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Do check out our other videos as well. Links to a few are on your screen. Please subscribe and do not forget to hit the like button. See you in another video. Thanks for watching.